हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज डॉक्टर सौरभ पटवर्धन फ्रॉम नंदादीप आई हॉस्पिटल एंड फेको ट्रेनिंग सेंटर। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल बी स्पीकिंग अबाउट लॉन्जिट्यूडनल वर्सेस टॉर्शनल फेको एंड व्हाट आर द एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस। सो टॉर्शनल फेको हैज सेवरल एडवांटेजेस, लाइक इट ग्रेटली रिड्यूसेज द रिपल्शन ऑफ न्यूक्लियस मटेरियल। सो दैट मीन्स द लेंटिकुलर मटेरियल स्टेज ऑन द टिप ऑल द टाइम एंड दैट फर्दर रिड्यूसेज द टर्बुलेंस of the anterior chamber, and the lens removal is very efficient. It was shown by Dr. Zacharias in his award-winning video. You can see in this video that the torsional phaco has very minimal or negligible repulsion, and that is the main advantage. Apart from that, torsional phaco also produces very less heat inside the anterior chamber as well as at the wound. It is compared to longitudinal phaco, and it was found that it is just 1/3 that of the longitudinal phaco, which is excellent because with torsional phaco energy, it is rare, or I would say almost impossible, to have a corneal burn. The same has been shown in various experiments where they check the increase in the temperatures around the phaco tip. But what are the disadvantages of torsional phaco? One of the major disadvantages is that in harder grade of cataracts, it may clog the needle, because unlike longitudinal phaco emulsification, which produces a clearing action of the hard material, the torsional cannot do that. Also, most surgeons using the torsional phaco first time complain of poor hold on the nucleus during the chop while using the torsional phaco. So why does this happen? So I did an experiment. So on one side, I am using 100% torsional phaco, and you can see how I can easily cut this nucleus while trenching using the 100% torsional power. It almost cuts like a butter. And on the second half, I use 100% longitudinal power for doing the trenching. And you can see that with 100% longitudinal, I can do good trenching. But of course, you can definitely see that with torsional, the trenching is very, very easy. Now, after completing the trenches on both the side, I measured the groove on both sides. So I used a 1.25 millimeter Sinsky just to compare the sizes of the groove. So when I compared the size of the groove made using 100% longitudinal phaco power, I found that it was just 0.9 millimeter, similar to the size of the phaco tip, while with 100% ozil it was wider, around 1.1 millimeter using the same phaco tip of 0.9 millimeter. So what happens when we do the chopping? In the groove made by longitudinal, the tip fits very snugly, and that's why the hold over the nucleus is better. While when we are using the 0.9 millimeter tip into the larger groove made by the torsional, the hold will be slightly poorer as compared to that when we are using the longitudinal. So this may be the reason why the better hold is achieved while chopping when we use the longitudinal power as compared to torsional. So what are my recommendations about using the two modes in different steps? So for trenching, I think the torsional is the best mode to use irrespective of the hardness of the cataract, because of no repulsion and excellent cutting ability without pushing the nucleus. I think torsional is the most preferred mode. And for chopping in hard cataract, as we shown in the video, that longitudinal or a mixture of longitudinal plus torsional gives the best hold on the hard nucleus. But for soft cataract, I think torsional will do enough for chopping, and there is no need to use the longitudinal phaco power in soft cataract chopping. Now for quadrant removal, when we are doing hard cataract quadrant removal, to avoid clogging of the phaco tip, as explained, we should use combination of torsional plus longitudinal, and that is the best way to do it. And for soft cataract, I think we can use full torsional mode, because there is no risk of clogging of the phaco tip, and we can enjoy the advantages of torsional phaco. So these are my recommendations to all the surgeons who are using torsional phaco machines. Thank you so much.